my heels nice and tight to my butt, so that way you can't put the grapevines in again, okay? Once I read, why am I doing it this way? Okay? So once I get to this low posture position, okay, can he still punch you here? Yeah, but there's not going to be as much heat on it, and a lot of times, go ahead and as he punches, a lot of times you'll be a lip punch. But not what we're doing right now. So, we posture this guy down, back, we got rid of his grapevine, okay? When I'm ready, okay, guys, notice how my grip shifted to one side. It's not straight around his back, okay? Hop out for 1 second, posture, okay? So this is the Pentagon, right? Does everybody see that? Okay? The Pentagon is going to be a much bigger shape right now than a rectangle. Does that make sense? So I'm trying to shoot my arm across his back towards the side that I'm looking. Okay, that's going to decrease the space he has to try to posture up, okay? And it's going to keep him nice and tight to me, okay? I'm going to be in a stronger spot. Okay? This also allows me, okay, got the grapevines out. This also allows me to have this elbow in a prime location, okay? Location. All right, so I'm going to straighten my leg on the side that I'm looking out, and I'm going to turn my hips, driving off this backside leg, okay? I'm going to scoop over top of his leg at the heel, and I'm going to control here, okay? What I'm trying to do next is I'm trying to use like his tibia and fibula I'm going to be pressing down with this back leg and lifting up with this leg, okay? I'm going to use my elbow to escape my knee, okay? A lot of times a guy's smart and keep his leg tight so he can't get a hook, so all I do is I use his backside leg to push and put this outside hook in, okay? From here, all the action is going to be going on this side. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to shoot my hips out this side, trying to maintain an underhook. Guys usually go wizard, okay? I'm shooting my hips out, getting this leg through, okay? That's where you normally go. But today, we're going to stop at this half guard point. And when we shoot, he's got a wizard we're going to work ours on. We're going to leave his foot inside. Does everybody see that on this side? I'm going to leave his foot inside. I'm going to shoot my underhook, and I'm going to keep his elbow tight to me. I start shooting my butt out towards the side of my underhook. I'm going to reach at a 45, and I'm going to use this half butterfly to sweep him at a 45. Okay, don't try to bring the person straight over. Try to bring him like over your shoulder, okay? So we're reaching here, and lifting, going over, immediately get that leg out, and establish your position, okay? You don't want to leave this here because now this guy's going to do the same thing to you. Go ahead all the way through. Okay, screw that through. Okay, I guess if you guys wanted to make it a drill for now, but I don't want this habit still, so fuck that. Okay. That was a lot. But we've been through hip escapes, I think, with everybody. Don't worry, Brandon's going to spend some more time with you working on that. Did the rest of that kind of make sense, everybody? We've been through hip escapes before and heel drags, yeah? Alright, any questions on the actual sweep itself? So we're leaving his half butterfly in, hopefully not in his junk or on his shorts, okay? You have to keep this tight, because if his elbow or hand get out on this side, okay, you're not going anywhere. Now, could you switch into something else? Yes. But we're here, we scoop here, some people like the hook, I don't really like the hook, I just like the cap. I'm going to reach across his back, trying to go to 45. Lift my leg, go over, get that thing out, swim inside.